Happy New Year. I'm Zac Sexton, former host of Fish Whispering TV. This is Hefe, 4-month-old German short hair pointer. We're out here on the first day of 2020 to catch some fish. We're in a small mountain stream with a variety of trout species and whitefish, the native fish. And, oh yeah, and there's suckers in here, and every once in a while, there's other fish. Hope you enjoy this. This is kind of my, no, this isn't really my comeback, but thought I'd jump back up on the internet and do some more outdoor videos. I always try to fish on days that are meaningful. First day of the year is one that's meaningful. Every day should be meaningful, and I hope every day you do things that matter. And make sure every action, every moment of every day means something. And it's actions that matter, not words. You'll enjoy this. Keep watching. Oh, look at that water. Oh, yeah. Oh, this is going to be good. Fish on. Native fish, I believe. Yeah. Beautiful. Silvery white fish. There we go. First fish of 2020. Native. Doesn't get any better than a native
fish.
On the end of a fly rod. All right, bud. See you later. Sweet. Beautiful fish. Let's see if my polarizers will help. There he is. Just hanging out after the release. And a puppy whining because he didn't go to smell it. Aw, buddy. That's Hefe. 4-month-old German short hair. Oh, bud. And some of you will be a little bit more excited by this non-native action. Even though it doesn't fight as hard, isn't as intelligent as, nor nearly as beautiful as the native whitefish, I guess, on a New Year's Day, 2020, we can make do with a brown trout. Whoops. Hey, bud. Healthy mountain fish, wild. Just a gorgeous fish. And taking the same fly as the whitefish, the wet carrot. Some of you may be wondering what a wet carrot is, and I'm not sure I can explain that to you without getting into trouble. But hopefully a lot of you know what the wet carrot is in general. And for those that don't, someday you'll know. But keep tuning in to Fish Whispering TV. Although there's probably going to be more stuff coming up. 2020, I believe, is going to be my comeback year. I figured since it's the second decade of the 21st century, I'd come back to entertainment, television, and video. But do a wider variety of outdoor sports. Field sports and water sports, but mostly hunting and fishing, shooting related. Dogs, we'll be working the dogs a bit. I have Hefe, and he's going to need some training. I plan on running him through some dog trials. I'd like to get him a lot of water time next fall, either this upcoming fall. He'll be going through pheasant hunting in South Dakota. Talk about that, but 2020, I'll come up with a branding name later, but for the fans of Fish Whispering, they'll still be fishing in wild places, enjoying native fish as much as possible, but it's not always possible. I hope you guys have a good year. This year's starting out just wonderful. A couple of fish to hand. And on a beautiful spot. It's really not that ugly right here. And I hope you're in a beautiful spot as well. Chetco the luck dragon. Testing his luck on the rocks. Which is great habitat for the stoneflies when they hatch in this river. In the spring. Well, actually, small ones in the spring, bigger ones early summer. Chetco likes to swim and he likes to climb. He's a golden retriever Kuvaz mix, 50-50. And he's a good old winter fishing dog. I mean, luck dragon. Cracks me up. Now what are you gonna do, bud? He'll figure it out someday. All right. Oh, that one got off. There's a decent school of whitefish right below me. You can see where... Oh, I think that was moss. You can see where the fast current hits that edge, and then right there where all that sand builds up. All right, so sand is a depositional material, meaning that it gets deposited with weaker currents than, say, boulders. Which would be more of an extreme example. So where you start seeing depositional material build up, you know you've got a break in the current. And here it kind of swirls around because of the boulder I'm standing on. And that makes a little bit of a dam, changes the direction of the current, swirls it around in here. And as it does that, it allows sand to be deposited. And fish will sit right there on the edge of that seam and wait for other things to be deposited there, which can include juvenile insects, caddisflies, mayflies, stoneflies, midges. Being that it's January, is most likely going to be the type of insect that we see in the water. And you'll notice I'm Euro nymphing. I'm using a semi-automatic reel. Boom. It's a Chinese knockoff, admittedly, because I can't really afford the brand name stuff and they won't give me a guide discount. So that's why. Just the facts. Well, I mean, I could, but I'd have to sell my... There we go. Oh, missed another one. There's a lot of different currents in there. I should probably have maybe a heavier fly on to break through that swirling current, but I'm kind of practicing some variation of French nymphing, which is using lighter tippet, which I'm using 5 and 5.5x, so it's not super light really, but for the Rocky Mountains, well, for the mountains that I am in, that's really light. This is fast, heavy water. The fish aren't necessarily tippet shy, but the lighter tippet allows your fly to sink more and for the currents to have less effect on how you drift your fly through. So I have effectively size 16 nymphs on and they're getting down to about 3.5 feet of water, maybe 4 where it's deepest. And I am bouncing the bottom. I'm gonna check the moss on my flies right now. That's the wet carrot. Looks clear, and that's just a red wet carrot. The other one's orange. Orange is my original wet carrot pattern. And it consistently outfishes everything else that I fish. I mean, everything. It's been such a good pattern. All right, drift after drift. I'm just trying to get the right drift down deep enough to where I can keep contact with the fly and set the hook hard enough. And I know most of these are whitefish. I mean, it's a whole school of them down there, so I'm mostly interested in playing the game of fooling them. They're not monsters, although there's a couple in there that are in the mid to upper teens. But it's just kind of fun fishing, and I really like just trying to fool fish. I'm gonna move in just a little bit upstream to where it seems like there's more trout in slightly different water. All right, drift after drift, just trying to get it right. Deep, deep, touching the rocks. watching the cider and watching the fish ignore my flies. That was the bottom. Saw that little yank on the line where it straightened out. That was a fish. So you get to the bottom, you find a fish. And you'll notice also, this is another invasive species, the brown trout. But it was sitting in on the edge of the whitefish school, so you don't always catch the fish that make up the pool that you might be fishing out of. And that's another reason why I just keep at it. Oftentimes, it pays off. All right, I have to take the camera off and sky go. You'll see the sky later. Hey, Chetco, bud. How you doing? Should we try this faster water and see what else we can come out of here? I think that's a brilliant idea. What do you think, Hefe? I think I'd knock you on the head with the lining net. Oh. This is Hefe's second fishing trip. He's not doing too bad. He loves being out here, loves sniffing around, but he doesn't really like being left behind, so. And trying to stick to small streams. And he's growing his winter coat. Hopefully not shivering so much. Hey, buddy. Okay, I've moved upstream a bit. It's his long drop. And then the head of that pool up there. So this water is a lot deeper. You see where the stream comes together up there. That pushes that water straight down. And scours out, makes it a little deeper. The stream's channelized a little bit, but there's a big, huge boulder right there that, again, helps kind of dam it up, and then you'll see that depositional material. I'm guessing, I have my polarizers on, so this all makes way more sense to me, I'm thinking, but there's depositional sand and small gravel out there, which means the current has slowed, and it is nice and deep. It's dammed up by these little boulders at the head of the riffle that I just walked through. And you'll see, there's fish in here. Hopefully, in just a second or two. You'll also notice, sorry about that, I'm filming myself with a phone / mini computer. I really don't think they're phones anymore. They're just useful computers. So I apologize for the production quality, but bottom. I think our lessons will be learned nonetheless. We're looking for deep, slow water. And I think, just from past experience, I'll get into more trout here. But who knows? Every day is a different day, and the weather's super mild. It's easily in the 40s. Possibly even the mid-40s, it was 50-something as I was driving up in the foothills. A little breezy at times. Here we're getting down. Trying to cross the current a little bit more. And I'll keep working my way up this way, just tossing the double nymph rig right on up. Orange and a red wet carrot, and if I need to, I'll switch stuff out, possibly bigger to get down deeper, but we'll see. Something will work soon. Okay, this took a little while longer than I thought it should have. But I was working up into the head of that run that we were just looking at, / pool. It's cool, I get the tail out, but until then, it's just this deep run. And you'll see I'm using this semi-auto reel to kind of bring in line.
I mean, if you're filming yourself, it's pretty handy. That's a beautiful trout. Oh man. Took an orange wet carrot. I put on a bigger one because this water is so fast in here and it's really deep, actually. Not right there, but where I caught it, up in there. We're hooked into it. Right there. There she is. Beautiful brown trout. And I know I usually say something not nice about non-natives, but I mean, they're here and they're wild, and there isn't much of a chance of natives doing well here because of what we've done in the past. Oh, but look at that beautiful fish. That is so awesome. I don't know. Brown trout, a little over a foot long on a bigger wet carrot on a barbless jig hook. And I need forceps to get out because it got in so deep on this filling mill hook. Tungsten bead from Tactical Fly Fisher, Devin Olson. I also get a lot of fly tying materials from Competitive Angler in Latrobe, Pennsylvania. See you, buddy. Boom, back to the darkness. Alright. Give me a minute. I mean, for this stream in this mountain range, that is a beautiful, fat, healthy brown trout. The spawn really wasn't that long ago. It's the first day of January, and this isn't really typical winter fishing conditions because it's in the 40s. There's not a lot of ice on the river. The water is still cold. Just a fantastic day and a fantastic example of changing tactics in the size of your fly and the type of water that you fish, and to be consistent and thorough in going through water that you're fishing. You can do this on any stream, anywhere where there's cold water fish, trout and whiteies, whitefish, grayling. And you can relax and have a good time. I hope your year is as productive as this first day of January has been for the dogs and I. And keep tuning in. I'll be online a little bit more this year. More to that story later. But take care, guys and gals. I hope you guys have a wonderful year. I've said that 1,000 times already. I'm gonna keep fishing. I hope you guys keep fishing. Just some different water than what I'm fishing. Happy New Year.